you clicked on this video because you've got a math test coming up tomorrow or sometimes very soon and you don't feel ready for it at all. Don't worry, I'm here to tell you exactly how to get started, how to find motivation in a situation like this, how to put things together, how to find sample tests, calculate your final grade, and more. For the best researched and practical advice that you could use inside and outside of school to help you do better in life, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button to get notified every time I post a new video. My name is Sepi and I'm the founder of Helix Academy in Toronto. I have been sharing my tips and tricks with my students for the past 9 years. These methods have helped my students turn their F's into A's. So if you're excited, make sure you hit the like button and stay tuned for the whole video because in the end, I will share a bonus tip with you guys. Number one is motivation. Let's be honest, guys, you didn't really prepare for this test, right? So you might be feeling a little bit of regret on why you skipped the classes, why you didn't study ahead of time, because you're going through a lot of stress and anxiety. But I want you to remember, if you pull yourself together right now, there is a good chance that you might actually pass the exam. And next time when you're put in this situation, you will actually end up preparing ahead of time, right? So what I want you to focus on is the good feeling you will experience once you're done your exam, once you leave the class. You know that overwhelming feeling that, you know what, I'm done? I want you to focus on that and use that as motivation to actually pull yourself together right now and study. So that's where you find your motivation. And I also want to remind you, this is no time to learn anything. You've already lost your chance. So what you need to focus on is to boost your confidence as much as you can and memorize more formulas and equations and questions as much as you can. So I'm gonna teach you exactly how to do that in step four. But for now, let's get motivated. Number two, create a tempo. I want you to get up right now. Well, not right now, don't pause the video, but I want you to get up as soon as you're done watching this video, go take a shower, put on some nice clean clothes, and come back to your desk. When you come back to your desk, I want you to clean it and have the minimal amount of items on your desk. I want you to have the fresh new stack of paper, one pen and one pencil, two highlighters, and pretty much that's it. So I don't want you to have your notes and everything else laying around because that's just gonna overwhelm you. If music helps you, make sure you play some music that has no lyrics in the background. You could actually search on YouTube for focus or studying music. Those also help, but if you're a type of person like me who works best at quiet spaces, make sure you create that for yourself right away. And lastly, let's talk about our phones. We're all addicted to our phones, and that's okay, but today you're not going to be addicted to your phone. What I want you to do is to pick up your phone right now, go through your notifications, and turn them off one by one for all of your social media and messaging. Tell your parents if you're not home and you're studying that you're not going to be using your phone. Put it away. Lock it in your drawer if you have to, but you're not going to be looking at your phone until after your exam. Number three, calculate your mark. We need to have a clear idea of how well we need to do on the exam in order to get a passing or whatever grade that we have in mind. So what I want you to do is to, instead of wasting time to learn how to do that, you can actually download the free calculator I uploaded in the description below, and I'm also going to write it in the comments. So make sure you click on it, download it, plug in your marks in there, and it will tell you what you should be expecting on your final mark. Number four, get the equations down. What I want you to do is to go through each chapter, and you want to start from the chapter that is most important and your teacher mostly focused on that or it has the harder test, and start from there. And I want you to write down all the math equations that are in there, and I want you to write it in a specific format though, so we can actually read over it and memorize it better. And the way you would do it is, in this example, I'm working with a logarithm equation, which actually tells you what your final investment value would be. According to this equation, A of T is your final investment, and A means your final investment, T means that your final investment is in terms of time. A naught is your initial investment. R is your interest rate, and it has to be plugged in the decimal format. N is the number of compounding years, and T is the total number of years. You also want to write down little notes that you need to remember with the equations. For example, with this one, you don't need to convert units. As long as the units are the same, the equation works. Number five, sample test. Now, this is the most important part of this process. So what you need to do is to find as many sample tests as you can on the subject that you're working with. So what you need to do is to just ask your older peers, people from, you know, in higher grades, if they have their tests. You can go online and look for it. You can use the end of the chapter review questions. Depending on your grade, sometimes they are very useful. And I'm actually gonna show you how to find online sample tests on there. So for example, if you're working with basic math stuff, you can do mathletics.com or analyzemath.com, whatever that works for you. But if you're doing more advanced subjects, you want to make sure you get pro in finding them online. And I'm just actually going to go on my computer and show you how to do that exactly. Okay, guys, so right here, I'm going to look for a grade 11 sample test, for example, and you can add the region you're from here. So to get specific sample tests to your region, then you just want to go through all of the links, open them up in a new tab. This is biology. We don't want that. Pre-calculus sounds good. And then I'm just going to go through them one by one. For example, this one looks like that it's giving you a final exam topics, formula, final exam review. So you might want to go ahead and click on that. And there you go. So you have a lot of questions that seem familiar. So when you get these questions, you want to go through the ones that look familiar and ignore the ones that you haven't done. So don't spend time on learning things that you don't know at this moment. You also want to go through some of the sources that give you a spot for answers. So you could just do the questions on your own and then come back here and plug in your answer just to make sure you've done it right. Okay, so now you know how to find sample tests for your grade online. Also, I'm really interested to know if your teacher actually gives you sample tests or not. So make sure you let me know in the comments below if you ever do get these sample tests or not. When you're going through your sample test, you know those questions that you can't really do? Make sure you highlight them in red. And the questions that you find them really good and you feel like those are gonna 100% show up on your exam, make sure you highlight them in yellow. So just gonna have an idea and have it organized for the next time you're going to review them. For the red questions, and I don't ever recommend this to anybody because I truly believe you only learn math if you practice and fail and practice and fail. And that's the only way you will ever learn math. But in this situation, we don't have a lot of time. The test is coming up. So what you need to do is to find the answer to those questions. There are a lot of ways you could do. You could ask a tutor, you could ask your peers, you could ask your teacher, email them and find out, but make sure you do that. Sometimes you can type the exact same question on Google and the answer would come up, or something similar to it will come up. And usually Khan Academy has an answer to it. So make sure you watch a video or go through a solution for a similar question, at least the question you're stuck on, and try to do the question again yourself, because the chances are those questions are gonna show up on your exam, especially if you have a lazy teacher. A lot of teachers like myself really like give similar questions to what they've done in class. So once you're done with those sample tests, make sure you focus on that and know exactly how to do the questions that your teacher has done in class, because they're gonna most likely post it in your exam. So now you're done studying. So what you need to do is to staple all the packages together. In each package, you'll have an equation sheet and you'll have your sample tests and questions that are highlighted and organized. If you're taking the subway or you're on your way to your exam, make sure you keep reading over those questions so it becomes second nature to you. And it's okay, I know you're told that you shouldn't be studying right before your exam, but this is not new material. This is something you've already spent time and you've already done it. And when you do that, it will help you boost your confidence. So you want to make sure you keep doing those questions and walk into your exam like a boss. My bonus tip is all about sleep. Now, if you're pulling an all-nighter, if you're worried about failing, it's okay to get 4 to 6 hours. Don't worry. Make sure you push through it. Make sure you get as much and as many questions as you can. But if you're not worried about failing, please make sure you get your 8 hours of sleep. It's so important that you get enough sleep because you let your brain recover and process information while you're sleeping. At the same time, make sure you stay tuned for more videos from me. My next video is going to be on how to write a math exam if you don't know anything. So make sure you subscribe and hit the bell button so you never miss a video from me. Thank you so much. See you later.